What's up, guys? I just thought I'd give you a little update on my teeth, as they have been in my care for close to a month now, at least for a lot of them. And considering that I need to actually refill the water dish on my auratum, I thought I'd actually try feeding her and see if she actually tries escaping on me again, because she pretty much does that every freaking time. Which is why I have her enclosure currently in this bigger enclosure even. So, let's see. Maybe she actually stays nice for once. That would be pretty much great. And apparently she gets used to the whole thing. So let me clean her stuff out in the meantime. And then we'll see if she's actually hungry afterwards. Well, as you can see, she's down there in the corner. I can try, without trying to spook her, zooming in a little bit for you so that you can see her a little bit better. She's easily spooked though, so she's very skittish. And yeah, this is Kamala. She's approximately 4 years old as well. I got her from a breeder here in Germany, and so far she's trying to basically find some routes to actually escape her enclosure, which, yeah, I know, it's kind of funny, but I guess I just have to pay a lot of attention to her, and yeah, I don't think that she can actually squeeze herself through, especially since these holes are pretty small. Anyways, let me try if I can find a cricket for her. She's probably going to actually jump and maybe try escape, which wouldn't surprise me, knowing her demeanor. But, yeah, let me try. Alright, here we go. Nice cricket. Nice. She got it. Cool. So, yep. Gonna refill her water dish in the meantime, since now she's eating, she's a little bit more cooperative, actually, knowing her. She usually actually never hides. She usually stays on top of that coconut that you see there, and never ever actually goes into hiding. So here she is again, so you can see her a little bit. And yeah, let's go. Alrighty, this is Fedra, my subadult female, P. irminia. After her molt, she actually ate a cricket, but as you can see, she completely closed her hide again, so I'll just leave her alone for now. Alright, this next little guy here is my Euathlus pulcherimaklaasi. He sits right there. I don't know if you can see him really good. Wait, let me switch the light. Ah, there you go. He's right there. He's still kind of brown colored, very dull usually. I mean, he's very small, still about an inch only. He is very skittish, and these guys are pretty fast too. Actually, I wrote a message to Tarantula Addict, Steve, and by the way, thanks for that. I received an answer from him basically telling me that these slings basically behave like G. rosea, and are also pretty much cared for the same way. Like, they like it very dry, they despise moist substrate, they are kind of having mood swings, they mellow out with age, and yeah, as he said, he wouldn't plan to ever handle his sling, although his adult female is mellow, but he wouldn't actually try it out. So I don't know, let's see if I can feed him. Well, usually he is kind of a voracious eater, but I don't know if he's actually going to take this one. got it. You took it. These guys are amazing at slings, actually, regarding feeding. It's insane what they are doing, actually. Okay, next one. Well, this is my bee smithy enclosure. And I don't know if she's hungry or if she's even wanting to come out a little bit, because she kind of retreated to her burrow a few days ago. And she sits right there, you can't see her, but she sits right at the entrance to the burrow, always looking out. She has fresh water, substrate is dry, temperature and everything is fine, and she doesn't look like she should be in pre-mold or anything. So let me at least try and see if I actually can coax her out, or if she's just wanting to stay for herself. Ooh, baby, what the hell? Doesn't seem to be in a really good mood, actually, currently. Let me see. Don't want to disturb her too much. Just come on out, show off, baby. Okay. Yeah, I'll leave her alone. She's just probably just wanting to have her own time, since she was kicking hairs a little bit when I touched her. So, sorry guys, you can't see her. She's really beautiful though, and usually pretty calm. She doesn't kick hairs at all. So I'm guessing she just wants to be alone and probably is just full. Next. Right. The next one you haven't seen either so far. This, actually, what comes now is my Avicularia metallica. And I bought it as unsexed. It's about 3.5 centimeters. And I'm actually assuming it's a male, or it will become a male, because his petal pops look a little bit like, you know, like this boxing gloves. And yeah, she's, or he's a little bit skittish, actually, when I open the enclosure. He usually walks very calmly, but as soon as I open the enclosure, he's kind of, you know, just getting skittish. So give me a second. I'll be right back when I've opened the enclosure. Alright, let me get the light. So, now I need to adjust the camera. Sorry guys, give me a second. I'm about to do it. There we go. This is my little pink toe. Like I said, Avicularia metallica species. And, like I said, he's pretty calm. I got him together with a GBB 3 days ago. As for new tea keepers regarding their temperament, I can show you what these guys are usually like from what I've seen, and mine is not an exception there. Just touching its leg very gently. See? I can literally pet his leg, or even his abdomen. He's very, very, I wouldn't use it, actually. I would not go and touch him, because I'm strongly against any kind of handling, unless it's by accident, you know, tea runs up your arm, stuff like that. Not because I'm scared, but just I think, leave these pets alone, especially since Avix really dislike the touch of human skin. So, as cute as it is, I don't know, I just, don't do it. Whoever wants to, I mean, probably it's fine, but, well, like I said, I don't really like it. I don't know, probably this little guy is actually not interested in food anyways. Let me see if I can actually move him out a little bit there. But, it's probably a little bit skittish currently. Well, let me show it. There he is, and, yep. He's probably going to take a run in a bit. There he goes. Little threat posture even. They do jump sometimes, so basically I spooked him a little bit there. As you can see, he's walking around the outside of his enclosure. I'm going to go and try coax him back in, actually, since I don't want him to be outside here, actually. Anyways. So, come on, little one. time to go back inside. And as you can see, they don't even have to do much. They sometimes even go in there by themselves. He's currently pretty much behaving like my Arminia. And there he jumps. He's kind of spooked, so I don't want to disturb him anymore. Or her. Anyways, these are my new additions, and hope you liked it. Rate and comment. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.